Hello guys and welcome back to my YouTube video. So it's been a while since I've actually done a video for ages, to be honest. I have just been that busy with work and stuff like that. I won't lie, I feel like just looking at the video on here now, my face has really come in and this cut. I'm definitely looking a lot leaner. I feel like my waist is starting to come in, which is, we're working in London, well, I say London, in Norfolk, so about 4 hours away this weekend. I won't lie, I'm absolutely shattered. Time today, so I might be able to film my push session. Back on it, I have had 4 days deload, which worked out well because obviously I was working away, so I was super busy with that. Because I was so busy, I didn't get my steps in, so I've got like an extra 10,000 steps to pretty much make up today before check-in tomorrow. I'm trying to think what else. I think that's about it. So yeah, definitely looking a little bit leaner. I feel like I've even got a bit of a chest split coming. Can we see? I feel like that's a chest split. That's a chest split coming, and I've not even trained yet, so buzzing about that. So I just thought I would get my pre-drinks ready. So got my big finger water, which I will put my EAAs, my Conti EAAs, my creatine, and my pre-workout. I'm not normally a pre-workout person, but I've started taking the Conviction Elite, the new one from Conti Sports. Holy shit, it hits so good. Yeah, the focus I get from this is so good. I don't really itch a lot with it, which is really good as well. I do dry scoop this because, I don't know, I just prefer dry scooping. And it's in mango sherbet flavour, which absolutely bangs. So, yeah, that's what I make for my drink, which I will drink throughout. And it also helps me get my water in and stuff like that. So, yeah, let's get cracking. Bodybuilding, how my training's going, prep and stuff like that for a while. This is the chocolate orange one, by the way, guys. It just bangs. It's just so good. I definitely should have put a lot more water in this, but I had a message from somebody who is going through a bulk, which the reason why I started this YouTube before the diet phase was because nobody really preps you for the bulk and how mentally it can be quite challenging as well, especially if you've been used to being leaner and you prefer the leaner look to then losing it and bulking for the first time. It is very, very difficult mentally. I've personally found it very difficult. And just some tips, I'd guess, from that side of stuff is keep in touch with your coach as well. Like, obviously let them know that you're mentally struggling with it, because they will obviously help advise you a lot more, and probably program a little kind of mini cut phase and stuff like that in. Some other things is just keep in mind what the goal is, and that is obviously to gain muscle. So focus on the strength, and wearing baggier clothing.
So as you saw in my videos, I obviously wore a lot baggier clothing than what I was used to, which did really help as well. When it comes to this mini cut, at the minute I actually don't feel that hungry. I don't think it's that bad. I'm losing weight quite steadily. Could be a little bit faster, but I've lost it faster in the past, but I don't know. I think my body just takes a little bit longer sometimes to respond. I'm actually really enjoying the cardio side. I enjoy it. I would actually happily ask Dan to up it, to be quite honest. But yeah, here's what it is. We just keep on trucking. It's not changed anything so far. So yeah, seems happy with it. After all, it is a mini cut. This isn't the actual prep. I'm gonna finish this and get off. Going into week 5 of the mini cut, and I'm aware that I've not actually posted since like the first day of it, so it's been a while. So far the scale weight hasn't moved that far. It moved quite a lot at first, and now it's not really come down at all, but the change is visibly, like, I don't know if you can see, I think I'll post a video of it, but like my chest split the other day was insane. Also, it is so warm in the UK. Doesn't agree with me. I should have been a ginger. And I literally just blow up. Like, I retain water like mad when it's hot. First week was like hard. But yeah, no, I'm just in the groove of it. Visibly so much different. Like, so much different. Especially this week, which has been really nice. Still, nothing's changed. So I've still got 5-30 minutes of cardio. I'm still on the same calories, literally nothing has changed whatsoever, and we're just dropping at a really nice steady rate. I feel so much more confident. I'm at that stage when you diet where you've got energy, you start to feel better about yourself again. So yeah, it's really nice to actually feel a bit better about myself, and just a bit more confident, and like I say, to have energy and feel fitter again. So like, I went for a walk at the weekend with my mum. And I won't lie, it made me realise how unfit I was by not doing any form of cardio, just getting a few steps in, like 10k steps, for so long. And yeah, I felt so much fitter. So it's really, really nice to feel better. I've had so many people compliment my physique as well, but it's mad because my waist has just come in so much, but yet I've still got, my shoulders are just massive. The transformation has been insane, but like I say, the last few weeks the scales haven't changed at all, and I've been, as always, I'm here for legs. The reason why I end up keep videoing legs is because I have Wednesdays off, that's my day off, and I just end up, it's the only time I have time to video, whereas with the upper sessions I'm normally quite rushed because I'm at work to get them done, and the lighting's shit at work. Not that that's a big deal, but you know, so yeah, either way, I've also got the Gymshark sports bra on. However, I'm feeling very exposed. Like, I feel like my boobs are just out in this. If I fall out of this today, you'll probably witness it on here. I don't probably. I just looked at my car. It's 22 degrees and it's only 9:30 in the morning.
always do it on my own, so I gotta get through it. And the only thing I know is to love what I'm doing. Never give up, never slow, till I finally prove it. Never listen to the no's, I just wanna keep moving. Keep my head up when I act, head up, that's a fact. Never looking back, I'ma keep myself on track. Keep my head up, staying strong, always moving on. Feel I don't belong, tell my thoughts to move along. Push myself to be the best, die with no regrets. Live with every breath, see my message start to spread. And I had so many dreams, then you hit your teens. Life ain't really what it seems, try to find out what it means. Always do it on my own, so I gotta get through it. And the only thing I know is to love what I'm doing. Never give up, never slow, till I finally prove it. Never listen to the no's, I just wanna keep moving. Yeah, I put out all the songs, it's my only medicine, yeah. Everything I do, I'm just being genuine, yeah. I'm sick of being screwed, feel my own adrenaline, yeah. I do just what I do, and I hope you let me in, yeah. I'm grateful, oh yeah. Able, oh yeah. I'm stable, oh yeah.
My little snippet into my leg session. I actually managed to video the whole thing, which makes a change. It is so, so warm today. I actually took this picture today after that leg session. I'll put it on here. I'm actually so proud of this. Like, it's so funny. So I sent it to Dan as well, because and also a back picture, because my check-ins just don't seem to do me justice. I don't know, my check-in pictures, because of where I do them as well, like, it's just bad lighting, and all the time I'm just like, Dan, I probably, like, I'm like, I don't know, this felt lean today, it looked lean, but then I'd show, like, my check-in photos just don't show it. So anyway, I sent it over to him, and he's impressed, so I'm happy with that.
So, I am in work, and I actually have a few hours to get my training done. So, today, I might actually video my upper pull session, which I don't think I've really videoed for YouTube yet. So, I am going to have to do it at work, though, because I don't have time to kind of go to my other gym and come back. What was I doing then? And I've come on my period about a week early. So I'm not feeling it. These deadlifts aren't going to feel great, but we do what we got to do. Yeah, headphones are going to go on. I'm not feeling it, I'm not going to lie. The weather's cooled down now, so it does feel like it's going to be better to train with. But yeah, I've got pull, so got some single arm lat pull downs. I think I've got some RDLs in there. I'll double check in this session. Some low rows. So we'll see how it goes, but I'm gonna try and video it and take you along. The lighting in this gym's not great either, so it is what it is. But yeah, let's go do a pull session.
Some of them want to use you, some of them
so pretty. Turn your back around in our district. You fight it all every time that I come around. I heard you rolling with the big girls now. Gotta quit right now, don't give a shit right now. I see you creeping every weekend, but you tell me I've got problems. Don't we all? But when the sun stops shining and the daylight's locked away,
I think you can even see how sweaty I am. Oh my god. It was so hot in there today. Not as hot as it had been, so that's good. But the cooking channel was on the TVs, which is a bit of torture. But either way, cook up some way, gonna finish my steps, and then back to work for me. Yeah, that was my pool session and cardio done. We are getting leaner. Definitely getting leaner now, which is good. I even had a bit of a bicep vein. Bicep vein, delt vein. My delt vein was popping, but you can't really see. Like I said, the lighting at work here isn't great, but we manage. So yeah, so food, steps, shower, back to work.
So I am very aware that this video is a little bit everywhere. I'm just getting my final steps in and just trying to chill out after a busy week. I'm very fortunate that I literally live in the middle of nowhere, so I can go for walks in places like this to get my steps in. There's been a change of plan, so I jumped on a call with Dan yesterday, and we've kind of changed the plan up. So basically, I am now, even though I've not been vlogging it very well, my apologies, about 5 or 6 weeks into, 5.5 weeks into a mini cut. It was going to be 8 to 10 weeks that we were doing a mini cut for, and we are extending it for 12 weeks. Because I am not competing March, kind of early 2024 now. So because I'm natural and I want to stay, I've decided I am going to stay natural, which means that most of the natural shows are also later on in the year, kind of like August, September time and onwards. So, sorry, this bit of road is so cobbly. I've got to concentrate. But yeah, so basically, because it's so late on, what we don't want to do is finish this mini cut, kind of rush a bit of a mini bulk and then go straight into like a 20 week diet phase. And because of the rate my body weight, my body fat seems to be dropping off, so naturally I gain muscle very quickly. But dropping fat, my body does not like. It likes to hold on to it. So the game plan is now mini cut a bit longer, go into another bit of a off season over Christmas, which is good because it means that I'm not going to be dieting at Christmas, I don't think, anyway. And then bit of a mini bulk, and then we're going to split the prep into 2 12 weeks with a little bit of a maintenance midway through, and we'll just see. So as you guys know from the videos, when I first started with Dan, my thyroid was screwed, hence why my body weight jumped up very, very, very quick when we were reversing them out of a cut that I'd done with the previous coach. So hopefully, fingers crossed this time, when I start to recomp back out of this one, I'm not going to gain the fact that the rate that I did, because hopefully my thyroid now works again. Also, if you don't know, this is a hill, hence why I'm getting out of breath, guys. And I've already done 30 minutes on the Stairmaster today. So, yeah, so that's the plan moving forward. So extended mini cut into another little bulk. Try and bring the legs up a little bit more. And then prep starts, which blows my mind, really. I won't lie. I'm feeling a little bit disheartened that obviously I'm not going to be competing as soon as what I wanted. However, that gives me more time to practice my posing, because I've been that busy, I've struggled. Gives me more time to work on that, more time to bring an overall better package. My legs definitely need it. My back is looking really good, but the legs need more work. So I'm happy with that. So my apologies for this being here, there and everywhere. I'm literally just going to try and get a load of all these videos, bits that I've tried to video together, put it all into one sort of mini cut mashup. I think that's what I'm going to call it. And that's that. I'm going to leave this video here, and I'm actually going to try and get a bit better at videoing. Thank you. Like and subscribe, and let's keep up with the journey.